You probably know that Tesla stopped fitting parking sensors to their vehicles, and instead they're using the cameras around the car and some clever software to give you that parking visualization up here on the screen. But Tesla were building and delivering new cars long before they had the software ready. And Tesla released these over-the-air updates, which get downloaded to the cars, and Teslas evolve and get better over time. And the parking sensors is one of those things which has very much improved over the last year or so. And this Christmas 2023, Tesla have released another new update, which has brought some extra functionality to the parking sensors. So before I show you that, let's just show you what we currently have before this latest update. So when you're reversing, the lack of sensors hasn't really been a particular issue when you're going backwards because of the resolution of the cameras. And as you can see, I've got a very high quality view out the back and also on either side. So as I reverse up to this bin, I can see exactly where the curb is, and the lack of sensors hasn't really been an issue at all. But it's when you're going forward, it becomes a bit more of an issue, particularly when you're parking. But what you are seeing is the current software here, and it is giving you a visualization of objects near you using the camera feeds. So as I reverse into this space where there is a bin, as I get closer, we can start seeing a line here and the distance. It's in inches because I've got the unit set to imperial, because in the UK we use miles. And as I get closer to that bin, it is saying stop there. So what we currently have with the Teslas is pretty similar to parking sensors. The issue is, though, this isn't particularly accurate. At the moment, the software and the visualization isn't as accurate as parking sensors would have been. And I often find it is just too sensitive, and it is saying stop when there's really quite a lot of gap still. A good example here is I'm going to pull into this bay against this hedge, and if I pull up to it, it can see the hedge and it's already saying we've driven over something. But we haven't. We're still a long way from the curb and the hedge. That hedge isn't overhanging the curb, but it is saying stop, 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 and I do now need to stop. But as you can see, it's saying the obstruction is halfway up the bonnet, and clearly it's getting the distance wrong there. So this is what we've had for some months now, but it's now Christmas 2023, and every year Tesla release a major update at Christmas time as a sort of a Christmas present to their customers. They hold back some of the new features until the Christmas update, and that's exactly what Tesla have done this year. And part of that update is quite a major improvement to the parking sensor visualization. So that's what we'll look at next. So it's now the new year. Actually, it's February when I'm recording this. But at Christmas, we got a new software upgrade, and part of that was the new high fidelity parking system. And now, rather than just a little line showing you objects around, you now get this 3D visualization of what is around you. So if I have a look, I'm next to that rapid charger again. I've got a couple of bollards. I've got a curb in front of me, a signpost there, and then a cabinet there with the hardware in for the rapid charger. And then when you're looking at an aerial view here of what's around, I can see the white lines on the tarmac next to me, and then I can see various bits of blobs, various bits of obstructions around me. And it's saying stop, so there's something in this front, or near this front corner, which is lit up orange and red there, so it's getting close to the car. But a lot of people have got confused by this and have posted on forums to saying, you know, is my car faulty? I've got this grey mess on the screen. When you're looking at the bird's eye view like this, yes, it is messy, and it's not obvious to some people what it's doing, but when you tilt the image, it then makes a lot more sense. And as we can see, it's got the rapid charger there, we've got the post and the obstructions and the cabinet, which is just there, and the hashing on the ground there, which is down there, and that blue electric car charger paint on the ground is here, and it's seeing all of that. And as I edge forward, it's saying stop, and we've got something close to the car there. And as you can see, it's low down and it's the curbs. Look at that, can even see a motorbike there, which isn't there. And that's now gone. Anyway, it thought something there was a motor. Oh, there we go, look at that, motorbike's back. I haven't seen that before. But this new system, while it's not perfect, it's very clever. So let's pull into this same space that I was recording back before Christmas, where there is a rubbish bin in this parking space. So as I pull up to the curb, we can see here that it's lighting up the curb in red and orange, because we're getting very close to that. And it's now saying stop. And yeah, I'm fairly close to the curb, but I'm quite confident I can do another inch or so. And as we can see, it's lighting it up red, and it is mapping the fence there and the hedgerows, and it is sort of mapping that rubbish bin there. Not particularly well, I thought it would capture the bin a little bit better. But we've got all of the bays, so you can get a feeling of whether you're in your parking bay correctly, and that's quite nice. But yeah, that's how the new parking system works. So where I found this works particularly well is going through a McDonald's drive-through, and it's tricky situations like that that this visualization system gives you that extra information, and it works pretty well. I'll put some images up on the screen, but as you know, when you go through drive-throughs, you've often got quite tall curbs and they're just not visible when you're sat in the seat in the car, and there's often bollards and it's quite easy to curb your wheels. But the system works reasonably well, but of course it's going to get better still, so it's all looking rather promising. Another thing it does is reads the white lines on the road. So if you have a look at the car parking spaces there, we can see them all there on the screen. So you can get a feeling of whether you're parked centrally in your space, or whether you're forward or back enough. But as before, when you're reversing, you don't really need this because you've got the high resolution camera feed. But it's when you're going forward and you've got the blind spots around the sides of the car and at the front, that's where this system is now starting to be really handy. And as I said, a lot of people online are complaining about this because they don't understand it. And also, this has only come down to vehicles without ultrasonic sensors as well. So people that have got sensors fitted to their vehicle, they haven't got this new system yet. But funny enough, those people are complaining, and they're complaining that they want it. But this still isn't as good as parking sensors. Parking sensors still work better than this. But at least now we're getting a feeling of where Tesla intend to take it. It's just a shame that they didn't have this software ready when they took the sensors off the cars. It's taken them over a year to get to this point. But we now have a feeling of what Tesla had in mind when they took away the parking sensors and said that they intended to go to a vision-only based system. And this is obviously what they had in mind. It's just a shame that they've taken a year to get this far. But anyway, at least it gives us that direction now. And while this isn't perfect, you can tell that it's very clever, and they've obviously struggled with this because they should have had this a long time ago. But anyway, with Teslas you get these over-the-air updates, and you can just imagine what this is going to be like in the future. And there will be incremental updates, and this system will only get better and better. So yeah, I would imagine throughout the year there's going to be further updates to improve the resolution, improve the graphics. We may even have colour in the future. So yeah, overall, I think this has a good future, and we'll end up with a very advanced parking system and spatial awareness around the car. So yeah, it's very clever. So I think that will do for this video. As always, if you found it interesting or useful, please do click the thumbs up button. That really does help. Do subscribe to the channel as well if you're not. And if you want to know more about the Tesla Model Y, I'll put a link in the video description below to a playlist where you can see those other videos. There aren't too many at the moment, but more were filmed and more will be coming over the next few months.